Hey, this is Prak, and today we have, you can see in front of me, I have the standard balance board and the new larger pneumatic tires balance board, and this is a customer of mine. I'm going to run some testing on it. His big complaint is that when he rides it, there seemed to be a sound coming from the tires, and he said that this pivot here is not that tight. So what we're gonna do is initially we're gonna test this out to make sure that this board works and how it rides. So go ahead, we're gonna test this out first. I'm gonna hop on it, go down the road and try to see what the problem is. I'll go ahead and mount this. Okay. I can actually hear the sound. I can hear the sound it makes now. And all right, and so it seems to me that when you do have this problem, you hear it? It's making these tough sound. It is working, but the problem with this particular board, I believe, is that the shell of it right here is pretty thin, and this is pneumatic. The tires here are pneumatic, so when you stand on it, you press down, what happened is you can see the clearing becomes tough, so it's skidding on here. So I'm gonna show you how to fix this problem. You have this board, I mean, this board is actually great for riding on grass and on surface that require higher clearing. So we're gonna go ahead and take this out and repair the problem. And today we'll be fixing an issue with this board. This board right now, if you look, this is the 10-inch board and it has pneumatic tires. When you step on it, what happens is the wheel, this raised down to the wheel, and so what it creates is this little grinding sound. What we're gonna do is take the shell off and we're gonna heat correct it using a regular heat gun, okay? And the first thing you need to do is make sure the power is off. In this case, the power is off. You'll need a Phillips screwdriver. Got my screwdriver here, and let's go ahead and start taking it apart. Okay, so it's a fairly easy board to take out. All right, so now we'll just work kind of clockwise. We can try to leave the screw in the shell. This pneumatic board right here is great for riding on multiple surfaces. For someone as heavy as I am, I find it a lot easier on my foot for a long distance ride. And this is a similar model, same specs as the previous one, but this, they decided to create an all-terrain version of this. Alright, so in my shop, we specialize in repairing these boards and also drones. And if you guys ever wonder how much it costs to fix yours if you have the problem, just give us a call. There will be a link below if I don't put it now, and click on that, you'll get to our website and you can call one of our sales people. And if you feel like you can do this yourself and all you need is just this parts, we will start carrying these parts too, replacement parts to replace these balance board. The version that we have in our store is called the Mag Board, short for Magic Board, and it's been customized. All right, so now you first thing you see is, you can see the inside, it is similar to the other one. What we're gonna do now is go ahead and disengage the power button and also the LED lights right here. All right, and then we'll go ahead and take the, this is the backlight right here, and the other one is the sensor. All right, put the plate away. Now let's concentrate on this one, this side. Okay. Let's go ahead and pull it out. Let's see what kind of battery it has. This logic board here is pretty decent logic board, but it looks like it has not been treated. When we get ours, we actually go in and modify it more, make it more rugged, make it more weather resistant. So our mag board, you can look at ours, and it retails for $750. We offer a warranty on it. So if you have issues, we can take care of it for you. All right, so now we have about 3-4 more screws to go. Okay. These shells are actually transparent plastic, and it's been painted on. The graphics have been water submersion adhesion technique. The battery is a pretty strong battery here. Let's go ahead and disengage the light. And what we're going to do is go ahead and release the battery. Okay, so let's take the power out of this, make sure we don't shock ourselves during the repair. So we need to go ahead and pull the battery connectors off. This is a little tough to pull, but you could pull the battery connector off. Okay, battery comes off, now it's safe to use. And what we're going to do is take the shell out. So now we got to go ahead and take more screws off. We're going to go ahead and take the screws off the bottom. There's two on the side. Okay. Take the screws off here, put it in a safe place. Take this screw off. All right. Let's go ahead and there are three screws in the bottom. It's holding the shell on. Let's go ahead and loosen those. You see, if you guys wonder about the speed control, this is the actual speed control here. If you go, you got a screwdriver, and you adjust it, it will, what it does is, it will either, you can increase the speed or limit, put a speed limiter. So if you have young kids, and you want it to, don't exceed 5 or 6 miles an hour, you can tone it down. Or if you want to try to speed it up more, you can also work on that, but that's at your own risk. We're not responsible for increasing the throttle on it. Okay. Take the screws off. Off here. Now there's three on top. Okay. Take that off. One more screw left, and then we should be able to remove the top shell off. All right, we're gonna heat correct this shell. Let's go and turn this over, and you're gonna pull it off. Okay, this release valve right here. All right, you snap that off, and now there should be a wire. There's a wire right here, and it runs through, and we go ahead and disengage that wire. You can see it right here. See this wire here runs through here, loops around. Actually, it's probably better just to take the light off. You can see this light right here. We can go ahead and disengage the light. We're gonna take the screw off there. It's better just to leave that wire there. It's easier to access it from the top. And this is the LED indicator. Okay. So, have that off. That's the LED. Okay. So now, as you can see, you see the bare board right now. And so what happens is, if you, once your foot press down, it creates pressure down here, downward pressure, which applies to here, and it reaches the speed controller, and it decides where frontward or backward right here. And this is in good condition. The owner also said that there's some kind of a slight jerk here in the pivot point, but I don't see the issue. Everything is well secure, so that's not a problem at all. But however, the cap of this, if you look at the cover here, the cover on this unit is a little loose on the other side. We're gonna have to fix that. Okay, so let's go ahead and take the other side off. Okay, let's go ahead and take the three side. All right. You got two more screws after this one. It's a little tight. Okay. It's two on top here, and then we should be able to free this one. And it's really important to make sure, before you do all this, make sure once you access this bottom plate, just disengage the battery. If this is high voltage, it's capable of killing you if you forget to take it out. All right, so what we're gonna do is remove the second plate here. Right, and again, there's a wire. What I want to do is go ahead and take this wire out. The board, let's go ahead and unscrew this. Free the LED sensor display. So once you get this off, what you do is remove the plate here and you look. So if you see this, this is what the bare board looks like. You can see why it can carry so much weight. Because once you take the shell out, it is initially a solid metal construction, a solid metal frame. Very strong. All right, so we're going to put this aside, and we're going to work on the shell. The big issue was the shell has a low relief, and it needs to be raised a little higher. All right, as you can see, this shell right here, the sound that we were hearing when we were riding it, was the fact that the pneumatic tires skidding on here. You can see the bottom of this frame right here, the bottom of the shell. The surface of the tires is rubbing against it, causing it to make that sound. So the owner of this board wants us to go ahead and fix it. The best way to do that is to use a heat gun. And we're gonna concentrate on adding heat in this area right here, weakening these. loosening the molecule of this plastic, and it'll allow us to actually push it back a little higher. Okay, so we can go ahead and start doing that. You're gonna need to move this back and forth in this pattern right here, and we might have to do it for about 2 or 3 minutes before the plastic actually shows sign that it's flexible. So we're trying to mold this back. We're heat correcting this issue. Alright, so once you get it to a certain point, we're going to leave this on for now. And you can see we can actually mold this back now. We're going to bend this upward a little bit. So I'm correcting the frame by adding heat here, pulling it up a little bit. As I'm doing this, I'm pulling it as I'm heating it up. Holding it up and I'm allowing it to cool. I'm flexing it back in and I'm allowing the board to cool down. And once it cools, what happens is the molecule will actually rest or lock back in. We're going to test it against the other board for now after it's done. Okay? As you can see, we're going to put it on here and test this board out. Place the pad here. And we're going to check the relief profile on here. And as you can see now, there's more room. You can see now the board should not be skidding. So we're going to do it to both of these, and you see the profile is raised higher now. So when someone is a little heavy and they ride on this, it won't push the pneumatic tire against the frame. So by adding that heat, it should work. All right, so before we put everything back into place, I'm just going to go over the details with this. This is the 10-inch pneumatic balance board, and I'm going to deem this the Magboard XL. And what you have on top here are the balance sensor. Underneath are the pads. This is the logic board. These are the power to the motor. The motor is actually inside. We open the shell up here. You'll see the motor, reference my previous video. You can actually see me opening the shell up. And the battery is right here, main battery. This is the balance sensor, and let's go ahead and tip it over. And these are the LED indicators, and these are pressure pads. What we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and reassemble this. Everything is done, the heat has already been applied, and now the frame has been corrected using heat. We can go ahead and put it back together then, okay? And so what we're gonna do now is go ahead and put the LED back into place right here. Okay, the best way to do that is to go ahead, turn it sideways, turn it upside down right here. And we'll go ahead and screw this in. Pull it a little further, and as you can see right here, we can go ahead and apply the screw back in. This is the screw we took off. I don't use a power screwdriver because it gives me more control when I use my hand. I like to actually feel screwing again and I know when it's tight or not. It allows me more flexibility. Alright, so let's go and put the other half in. Okay, this is the LED indicator. Let's go ahead, once we get that done, we're going to put the pads on for this one. So this is the pad for it. Apply it snugly. Make sure the seals are in the well right here. And this is a water resistant seal. Let's go ahead and place this into place like we have here. Alright, a little tap. And pull this up a little bit. Alright, now we're going to go ahead and put the pad on the other side. Okay. Let's take a look at this right here. Okay, you can see this is actually loose. So we're going to correct this by using SGX. Alright, so this seal seems to be broken from the manufacturer. So what I'm going to be using is my SGX digitizer seal. This is silicone based adhesive. I'm going to apply a little bit just to seal it off. See, just put just a small amount right here. And now when you put this down, the seal will hold. And what we're going to go over, while we have the SGX here, I'm going to show you how to actually help prevent moisture damage to this board. We're going to use this SGX right here. We're going to see these connectors here. We're going to go ahead and seal, put SGX here to actually hold off the moisture. These components can easily be damaged. So what we want to do is go to key components where the connectors are and put SGX on it. Put one on this side also to seal it. Okay. This will prevent short circuit. Put a little bit on the board here. All right. And now we're going to go ahead and put the other half on. Okay, this is the LED indicator for the power. Put the pad into place. Make sure they all rest on the seal. It can respond properly. Put the shell, this two tips are here, goes into the hole. Okay, now we're going to turn this upside down. We're gonna plug in the components in. Well, actually, we're gonna put the screws in first. So we can go ahead and put these top shell screw on. Okay, so now we got the top shell on both sides, what we're going to need to do is go ahead and put the wiring in place. We're plugging up the LED. Now we're going to plug in the charger cable. And this is the power switch. Okay. Power switch in. If any of these comes loose, the problem is you won't have a working board. So we're going to use my STX again to seal the clip here. To seal it. This will prevent it from coming loose because this is meant to be off-road. So we're sealing it. Okay, let it seal. And doing a system check, everything's in place. We can go ahead and put the shell back on. The bottom half right here. Into place. Alright, so now the shell is on here, we can go ahead and engage this. Let's go ahead and put the LED in place here. And again, I'm going to use my STX to hold it, to also weather seal it from moisture. STX around here, just keep it sealed. And now we're going to engage the battery. So, go ahead and plug the battery in. To place. Okay. Gotta be really careful with arming it. Now the battery's in place. Before we seal it, we're gonna test it out real quick. Turn the power on. Alright, you can see it does work. Turn it off. Now we're going to close off the seal. And after this is done, everything is good to go. All right, so now it's completely built. It's ready to go. Weather seal's on. I'm going to go ahead and test this out. Power it up. And now let's see if it makes that sound again. As you can see, does not make that sound anymore. Perfectly quiet. No more grinding sound. All right, let's just test it in different terrain here. Let's go ahead and test it on the road. All right, we're gonna go ahead and test this on the road surface. How it does. All right, so we're going on the road now testing it. As you can see,